PSEP. My name is Ella and today is Monday, September 28th, and I'm here with today's announcements. I'll be starting with a few club announcements first. Attention all students interested in advocacy and healthy living. Health, right now, is a club for those wishing to plan large-scale activism initiatives related to public health. Past events have included a workshop with the University of Michigan and COVID-19 relief fundraising. For more information, contact Ms. Starr. Attention Plymouth Juniors, Class Council will be having their first meeting on October 1st at 2:30. If you are interested in joining, email Ms. Starr and you will be sent the Zoom link. Hope to see you there. SAD, Students Against Destructive Decisions, will be holding their second meeting of the year, virtually, on Tuesday, September 29th at 7:40 a.m. Email Ms. Sutherland to get the link to our Zoom meeting. Are you interested in joining robotics? You can contact Lightning Robotics at their website, www.lightningrobotics.com, or email us at 862first@gmail.com, 862.FIRST@gmail.com. It is not too late to join and develop your tech and business skills. Looking for a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity? Well, spaces are still available to travel to Iceland with other students from PSEP on spring break. For more information about the trip, email Ms. Lang at Salem. The Career Center is excited to announce new virtual Zoom visits for colleges and military. If you want to attend a live Zoom presentation, fill out the Google form for each visit you want to attend. Students who fill out the form will receive the Zoom link invitation in a confirmation email. Forward the confirmation email to your teacher so that you're not marked absent from your class. Sign in to the virtual Zoom visit within the first 5 minutes so that you'll be recorded as present. Sessions may end earlier than the started times, but they will start on time. Tuesday will be Central Michigan, Thursday is Wayne State, the Army, and Michigan Tech. Next week, Tuesday, is the University of Michigan, Ann Arbor, and Grand Valley. Go to the PCCS website and search Career Center for all times and details. That's all for the announcements. Next up, Allie with the news bit.
It's a year for change, PSEP. I'm Allie with your news bit. 7 in 10 American parents say that they're going to radically change their approach to their kids' lunches and dinners this year. Half of the parents say they're using back to school as a way to get their kids back to eating healthy and a way to backtrack all the comfort food that they started eating in quarantine. The study of 2,000 parents came to show that 79% say that they're going to stock up on food differently and have a better outlook on their kids' eating habits. Many are seeking to reduce sugar intake and boost plant-based food consumption, as well as stocking up on fruits, nuts, vegetables, and kid-friendly foods like hummus. Hopefully we can all get into a better eating habit this year. See you soon, PSEP. Have a great day.
Hey, PSEP. Hope everyone's doing well today. I'm David with your sports for today. Starting off with NHL news, the Tampa Bay Lightning lead the Dallas Stars 3-2 and play tonight at 8 o'clock. In the NBA, the LA Lakers have advanced to playoffs in 5 games, while the Heat and Celtics still continue to battle. 20-year-old rookie Tyler Hero has been a real standout on the Heat, coming out of nowhere and scoring 37 points in Game 5. In high school sports, our very own PSEP football teams have started competing as well. Currently, Canton stands 2-0, Plymouth 1-1, and Salem 0-2. Good luck to everyone for the rest of their season. That's all for sports. Have a great day. Peace up.
Hey, Peace up. This is Madeline. Today I'm going to take you on a trip to Cedar Point, COVID-19 style. This year, because of COVID, Cedar Point has decided to do things differently inside of their amusement park. Everyone inside the park must wear a mask and maintain a distance of 6 feet from other guests not in your party. There are employees around the park making sure everyone is wearing a mask. There are designated places around the park people can take their masks off to take a break. Cedar Point also has tickets for all of the popular rides, so you could get in only at certain times for that ride. This prevents crowds from forming around those rides. In line for rides, everyone is 12 feet away from the person in front and behind them. You are 6 feet away from the people in line that's next to you. Cedar Point ensures a safe and fun time while enjoying rides and entertainment while inside of the amusement park for everyone. Usually during this time of year, Cedar Point will hold a festive, fun-filled entertainment, which they call Halloweekends. This year, they had to change a couple of things to ensure the park is safe for attendees and employees. Inside the park, there are Halloween decorations everywhere. Many of the employees and guests are dressed up in costumes. If a guest chooses to dress up in a costume, they can head to a station around the park to get candy. That's the end. I hope you enjoyed taking a trip with me to Cedar Point. Make sure you tune into next week's segment. Thanks for watching, Peace Up. Tune into our YouTube channel, STS Announcements, to watch the full clip.